I'm sadly holding your hand.
When it comes to going green, everybody knows to recycle and, of course, to carpool.
Yep, we've all been told that. Well, now you can go green when you eat. Nutrition stylist Holli Thompson is here with some easy ways you can go green when it comes to meals. Hi, Holli, how are you?
Hi, great to see you.
So we can really do this. This isn't a hard task, you say.
It's not hard, and actually what I wanted to talk about today are kids and packing healthy meals for our kids. Mm-hmm. And I'm very inspired by Michelle Obama's new initiative, the Let's Move initiative. So, I love the way she's really reduced it down to some very simple steps. So that's what I've brought to show you. And we want to make it easy. I work with a lot of busy people that need to make it easy.
Well, a lot of parents can certainly relate. This time of the year, they're already thinking, oh, those back to school lunches.
Exactly.
What a drag, and what a kind of a boring routine it can become unless you have some go-to things, right?
Absolutely.
So how do we do it in a healthy way that's not so hard to do?
Yeah, what'd you bring with you?
Well, first of all, I love this little lunchbox, and I know you both want one.
So adorable. I love the color.
Isn't that great? That's from Lunchopolis, and that comes with wonderful little containers inside that stack up and fit perfectly so that there's no waste. So therefore, we're calling it green because hopefully the containers that you send to school with your child come home at the end of the day. And that also has a BPA-free little water bottle inside, which is very important. We don't want to give our children, you know, thin water bottles anymore. That's something
because there's been research, of course, that has said that it being stored in those water bottles can contain chemicals, toxins that could get into our bodies.
Yeah, absolutely, they're leaching toxins.
You look for this label that says BPA-free on it, and then that plastic is okay to use.
That's right.
And so, I see this is also lined with something that sort of keeps things cool, I guess.
Keeps things cool.
Very nice.
Exactly. Yeah. So it's a great little lunchbox. That's my favorite lunchbox this year. And what I did was I packed some sort of an ideal and then some easy solutions for us. Okay. So this is a little almond butter and jelly sandwich. So I am liking almond butter these days instead of peanut
butter. Substitute for the PB&J,
exactly. And it's a great alternative for kids that have peanut allergies. I also love Udi's gluten-free bread. Udi's is a really delicious gluten-free bread, and a lot of kids in America now are going gluten-free. As you may have noticed in the grocery store, it's a fast-growing food group.
And it's good to see that there's more options for people that have no choice but have to go gluten-free because what's going on with their bodies.
Absolutely. And this is a very tasty bread, so Udi's, U-D-I. The other thing that Mrs. Obama wants us to focus on, part of her initiative, is to reduce salt, fat, and sugar and add in whole grains and double our fruits and vegetables. So how do we do that? Well, the easy way would be to pack a little container of, you know, these lovely little tomatoes and some organic ranch dressing. But if you don't have time or if you've run out of tomatoes, what are some easy ways to get some whole fruit into our child's lunchbox or into our lunchbox? So I brought some little samples. This is a great one from Cliff Kids. This is 100% fruit, no added sugar. It's a great alternative. These are little fruit strips from Whole Foods.
Now you need to be careful with the strips, right? The ones you got have more fruit in them, but you could easily see something, you think it's fruit and it's full of sugar.
Absolutely. These are 100% fruit. So we want to look for 100% fruit with no added sugar, and organic is best.
And you get it in, I would assume, in the organic aisle of the grocery store?
In the organic aisle, or if you go to a healthy store like Whole Foods, they're pretty easy to find.
Okay.
So be on the lookout for those. The other thing that I love to do, this is my little trick.
Vegetables in a little container.
Well, these are actually apples.
Oh, apples.
And they're whole apples that I've cut into little bite-sized bits, sprinkle them with some organic cinnamon, and by the time your child has lunch, it tastes like little pieces of apple pie.
And you're tricking them to eat the apple, and it tastes much better, right?
I'm also hiding the browning of the apple.
Very smart.
And I came up with this one day out of desperation because I was so tired of having an apple come back every day in my son's life.
And that would be a perfect excuse for a kid who opens it and goes, these are brown.
It's
brown.
I'm not going to eat it. And one day I just went, you know, and shook it up. And there you go. And it's really good.
And what is it about cutting up the apple that all of a sudden, because it's in bite-sized pieces, they'll pop in as opposed to just having the whole fruit?
Right, absolutely.
You've got to do a little work for them, right?
Right, absolutely.
You have to make it look good. Make it look bite-sized. Snackish.
Mm-hmm. So another great way to, we talk about adding in vegetables. I love this. This is a SpongeBob edamame package. So if you don't have time to put together your tomatoes and ranch dressing, which seems so so simple, but we all know how it gets. Mm-hmm. This is a little package of
perfect
SpongeBob edamame.
Wow,
so
and that's
we have
full
organic,
of protein.
And it's organic, so organic companies are starting to get on the bandwagon and make kid food that looks attractive. So your organic child doesn't feel like the oddball when
everybody
he's having
else
his
in the
lunch.
Cafeteria has the Twinkies. And
exactly,
all the
other cool and his
stuff.
Friends are all eating, you know, characters, cartoon characters on their whatever, on their bags of snacks.
He may be the coolest one with this little packet, right?
So. Right? I think that's right.
And I think most kids probably like the taste of edamame.
They do.
It's pretty tasty.
Kids love
most
edamame.
Like that. Yeah.
So we also, Mrs. Obama also calls for adding in whole grains. So a perfect whole grain is popcorn. So just buy some organic popcorn, make your own organic popcorn, put it in a BPA-free container. There you go.
Also very cheap. I want to get to one of your drinks because we're running out of time.
Absolutely.
So pick the best one you have here on the table.
Coconut water. I love coconut water.
Is it this one?
The coconut water. Coconut water is ultra hydrating. It's a great sports drink for kids. It's the secret of the Brazilian soccer team. And I think a lot of our sports teams in America are getting hip to it. I hear the Orlando Magic have switched over to this. Straight up, as they say.
What's the benefit of this drink?
It's low. It has 8 times more electrolytes than the leading sports drink. So a lot of the sports drinks that they're selling in America are loaded with high fructose corn syrup and sugar. This is 100% pure coconut water, ultra hydrating, low in calories, by the way, and a great drink for us moms too.
Very good to know.
Yeah.
No chemicals.
I recommend it to my clients. It's
Holli,
great.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Learned a few things today. Thank you, Holli.
Thanks.
All